Twin port inlet manifold and cylinder head systems are common in vehicles. I use the Corsa D as the explanation example, including how to test. Air is drawn into the inlet manifold via the MAF and the throttle body. There are two ports for each cylinder having two inlet valves. The swirl flaps in the inlet manifold are controlled by the ECU. Under low rev conditions, one of the swirl flaps closes off one of the ports. The profile of the first port causes a vertical vortex, ensuring correct fuel-air mixture entering the cylinder for low revs. Under high rev and load conditions, the swirl flaps open the second port, causing a horizontal twin vortex responding to change in engine demands. The Corsa D uses a small vacuum actuator to operate the swirl flaps. The swirl flaps default to the closed position once the engine is started. The twin port system is designed to provide more efficient engine fuel economy, power and reduced emissions. I show the test of the actuator on the bench for clarity, but it's easily done whilst on the car. Disconnect the vacuum pipe to the vacuum solenoid valve and connect a vacuum pump as shown. The actuator should operate moving the arm and hold it in position, that is, not leaking. Release the vacuum and the actuator should move the arm back without assistance. The vacuum solenoid valve provides and cuts off inlet manifold vacuum negative pressure to the swirl flaps actuator. The actuator moves all four swirl flap arms and thus the inlet manifold flaps to one of each of the twin inlet ports to each cylinder. The voltage to the solenoid is controlled by the ECU. Firstly, test for a coil resistance. There are just two terminals. Connect in either direction. You should expect a resistance of about 30 ohms. Next, test to see if it holds a vacuum. I use a cheap vacuum gauge. Obviously, you can suck down the tube if you like. Whilst maintaining a vacuum, put 12 volts across the terminals. You should hear the solenoid operate and the vacuum should drop to zero. If it holds a vacuum and operates when 12 volts is applied, clearly the solenoid is doing its job. Bringing the test together on the car, ignition off, remove the connector to the vacuum solenoid valve. Start the engine, then provide 12 volts to the terminals. Polarity isn't important, the actuator should operate. Next test. With the ignition off, connect the connector to the vacuum solenoid valve. Start the engine and check for battery voltage at the connector by back probing. Voltage is zero until the engine starts. It seems obvious to me that fuel trims can be affected if the swirl flaps don't operate as designed and when they're supposed to.